Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to God, our salvation.
Let us come before God's presence with thanksgiving.
And praise God, shout to the Lord in psalms.
For you, Lord, are a great God.
And great ruler of all gods.
In your hands are the caverns of the earth. Is yours, for you made it.
And your hands have molded the dry land.
Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. Oh. All that today we wouldn't hear.
step. It is an individual journey through the sand that strengthens these creatures. Then they are ready to face the ocean's waves. We are much the same. We must face the future, all of it, the glorious mountaintops, but also the dark valleys. We will grow stronger every day. Eventually, after we have looked up a thousand times over and found the Lord right at our side, we will begin to trust Him more. He knows what tomorrow holds. He knows where we're going to be. We need to trust Him with our future. With all of our heart, trust Him. It's very easy when thinking about God's plans for our lives have as it's all about me. It is very true that God cares about even the littlest details about us. Jesus said that even the hairs on our heads are numbered. Many Christians mistakenly think that God's plan is always going to make us feel good and has intent to make us happy. You can read this passage and get this warm, fuzzy feeling. You can think, oh, how wonderful. That is so lovely. What a great passage to share with those who are starting something new in their life, such as graduates, a person getting a new job, or someone moving to a new town. But do we Christians know the true meaning behind it and who is the real audience? Jeremiah was writing to the Jewish exiles in Babylon. They'd been taken from their homes. They were in a strange land, a foreign land. Perhaps they weren't sure why God would allow them to be taken captive. Perhaps they hadn't given much thought to God and His commandments before captivity. Perhaps they weren't even turning their hearts towards God at the time Jeremiah was writing. At least not yet. And Jeremiah wasn't promising them an immediate deliverance either. He was telling them, you'll be there 70 years. But it's okay, because those years are part of God's plan for you. The situation may seem dark to you. You may not see much hope in being where you are right now. But God does have a plan for you. You have not been forgotten. Today, in the midst of this difficult situation, God wants us to know His plans for us. He also wants us to know that as we commit to His plan, He uses us to bless the world around us. God has gifted us with unique interests, talents, skills, and abilities. We have been blessed to be a blessing to others. Jeremiah 29:11 shouldn't be seen as a generic come one, come all promise. Can God use this verse to work in the lives of believers? Yes, absolutely. It states that the plans He has for us are for good and not for disaster, to give us a future and a hope. If you're thinking in terms of wealth and prosperity, in terms of having a good life, a great life, a perfect life, where you get exactly what you want, when you want it, a problem-free life, where everything always goes your way, you have misunderstood this passage. God did not promise us an easy life. God never promised that we'd always be happy and comfortable. God wants to shape us, transform us, make us whole. He wants obedience. He wants our hearts and minds and lives. As Christians, we should focus mainly on the second part, where we place our focus. In Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 6, it states, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take. Trust Him with all your heart, and then acknowledge Him in all your ways. What that means is to pray, go to God for everything. Praise Him for who He is and what He's done. Sometimes you will not understand my ways, says the Lord. In such times, you must trust Me. Do not depend on what you can see before your face. Sometimes you must simply walk in faith. Faith is trusting in what is not seen. Faith is grasping that you don't have to know everything, because you are held in the hands of the One who does. And if you're doing that, if you're trusting in God and going to Him in prayer and seeking His will for your life and for the decisions you have to make, you know what happens? He'll show you where to go. He'll show you what to do. He will give us a future and a hope. God's timing isn't always our timing, and our idea of the future isn't always God's idea of the future. So, class of 2015, as we go on our way and face difficult situations, trust in the Lord with all of our heart, and He will show you which path to take. As we face difficult situations, don't forget to trust in God's plan. There will be times when we are afraid something will not come to be. When we realize that we have strength from God, we will wonder how we got into a certain situation. We will look to our left and our right and see that there will be no escape. It may feel like we are alone. Just remember, in those times, that God is our good shepherd and we are His sheep. We know His voice, so we must listen for it. I will gather you up close in my heart where you dwell. I am yours and you are mine, says the Lord. It may not always seem like He has a plan for you, but He does. God God is promising us that He knows our plans, and they are plans for good and not for disaster, to give us a future and a hope. What a beautiful promise from God. We are going through this together, and even though our pathways are all different, we all have that one thing in common. We don't know what tomorrow holds. But just remember, God does. So put your trust in Him, trust with your future, trust Him with all of your heart. God knows what's best for us, therefore you can trust God with your future. You can trust Him with your failures, and you can trust Him with your fears. Because after all, He is God, and He is ever-present help in times of trouble. I just want to leave you with this. No matter what life brings your way, no matter what circumstances or situations you go through in life, no matter if it's smooth sailing or stormy seas, trust God.
valleys, and victories, and through all these seasons, our lives we need to hold onto the promises given to us in Philippians 4, 1 through 3. I can do all things through Him who gives me strength. No matter what kind of tree we are, we need to have strong roots in Christ. No matter where you are at in your walk of faith, your roots can grow deeper into Him and let your life be built by Christ. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth of God. We need to have roots like the tree in Jeremiah 17, 7 through 8. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. He will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green, and it has no worries in a year of drought, and never fails to bear fruit. We all are our own kind of tree. God has given us each a special talent, whether it's being an athlete, musician, a speaker, a builder, a listener, an advice giver, or a teacher. We all need to use our talents to glorify the one who has given them to us. So when we go out and pave our new paths in life, we can continue to use the talents we are given and find new ones to grow our roots deeper in Christ. By using our talents, we can be a blessing out to others and live the life God has planned for us. As we journey through this life, the roots we have built will help us to face different seasons. We will all face the season of summer, where we are filled with joy, laughter, and the warmth of the sun. During this season, we are happy and thankful for all the good things. Then summer slowly fades to fall, where when you think of fall, you usually think of change. Everyone faces change at different times. As we move on and meet new people, we may be filled with anxiety or fear of unknown change. We will face new jobs, classes, new people, and new responsibilities. As we face these new obstacles, we need to adapt to new circumstances, like the cold of winter. Winter is a cold and dark time when you feel you're at your lowest. Maybe it's the death of a loved one, or you become financially unstable. Whatever it is that makes you lose your leaves, and the night seems so long, know that these life storms cannot shake you, because you know too that this is only a season. With family, faith, and friends, and God's strength, we can make it through these tough seasons. After the darkest of times, there is always hope. Like spring, all things bloom again, and things turn green. His strength is with you through all these seasons of life, and your roots will grow even stronger. You're seeing new sprouts and reaching further than ever. New opportunities blossom that you never thought possible without gaining the strength that we did by going through the storm. So as we go into this big forest of a world and face our own seasons, may we be confident in this strength and the roots we have grown here at Dawson Boyd. The friends, family, teachers, coaches, leaders, and community that have helped us grow deep roots in faith are unwavering. May we all find courage and strength and stay rooted in Him. Class of 2015, grow your roots deep. Find your fruits and your life seasons, and know that you can do all things through Him who gives you strength.
Please join me in prayer. Dear Lord, as we all go our separate ways, I pray that you will continue to watch over us, guide us, and support us with all the obstacles we may face. Amen.
And now as you go on your way, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with